Hello everyone, welcome to video lectures on system simulation and modeling, module 2, continued statistical models in simulation. So now we are going to study queuing models. So in these queuing models, we are concentrating mainly characteristic of queuing system, queuing notations, long run measure of performance of queuing system, steady state parameters of the M bar, G bar 1 queue, network of queues, rough cut modeling and illustrations. So first of all, we should discuss queuing models. So generally, simulation often used in the analysis of queuing models. In a simple but typical queuing model, so the customers arrive from time to time and join in a particular queue, that is a waiting in line. So which are eventually served and finally leave the system. This is called as a queuing system. The term customer refers to here any type of the entity can be viewed as requesting service from the system. So therefore, we say that here many service facilities, production system, repair and maintenance facilities, communication and computer system, transport and material handling system can be viewed as a queuing system. So even though queuing model, whether solved mathematically or analyzed through simulation, provide the analyst with a powerful tool for designing and evaluating the performance of a queuing system. So now we should discuss one by one. First one is the characteristic of queuing system. First one is the characteristic of a queuing system. So in the characteristic of a queuing system, there are points we need to be, sub-points we need to be discussed. The calling population, the system capacity, the arrival process, and queuing behavior and discipline, service time and service mechanism. Then followed by the queuing notations. So the first one is, we know that in the characteristic of a queuing system, so in generally there are a lot of examples we should take it as a queuing system. So for example, we should say that customers and server, if you consider as a particular system, so garage, trucks are the customers, servers is a mechanic. Similarly, hospital, patients are the customers, nurses, including doctors, are the servers. So even though airport, airplanes are the customers, runway are the servers. Like that, in a grocery shop, shoppers are the customers, checkout station are the servers. So, in case of computer system, computer or email are the customers, thus as in the CPU, disk are the servers. In telephone, calls are the customers, exchange are the server. So, this is the case, queuing system. The key element of the queuing system are the customers and server. Here, the term customer can refer to people, machine, truck, mechanics, patient, valet, airplane, email, cases, order, so and so. For that. The term server might be, again, this is the case, receptionist, repair personnel, mechanics, medical personal automatic gas storage or retrieval, so and so, then we can call it as a server. So this the thing is, so whatever that servers or customers, how that going to interact with a particular system. So first we should take the main key element here. One is the major characteristic is the calling population. The population of potential here, the population of potential customers is referred to as calling population. So it may be assumed to be a finite or infinite. There are two ways we can call it is, one is finite customer or infinite customers. Say an example is, a very good example, in the petrol pump, it is infinite customer arrival. Because 24 into 7, any system which belongs to the infinite calling population. So another thing here, next we say that an example is a restaurant, petrol bank or hospital, university, whatever it is. The main here, the main difference between the finite and infinite population model is how the arrival rate is different. The finite, actually the arrival rate is depends upon the arrival of the customer, and there is no difference at all in the infinite system. For example, in the petrol bunk, the people are coming and waiting in the line. It doesn't affect the entire system because this entire system which is running by 24 into 7. There is no queue in this, and there is no waiting because all should be eventually served one by one because it will run as in a 24 into 7. But in a finite, there is a automated or some garage showroom, or you can call it as a washroom of the particular wash of a particular car or bike. That should have 9 to 5 or 9 to 6 with our appointment. So appointment means appointed car, or they are going to us only appointed car or bike, not more than. So this is called as a infinite system. So an infinite population model, arrival rate is told that not affected by the number of customers. Usually nothing to have any n number of customers. So next is the system capacity. So here we say that in many queuing system, there is a limit to the number that may be a waiting line or system. The system capacity, again we should take an example like that is the automatic or atomic car wash might have room for only 10 cars to wait a line to enter particularly mechanism, and arriving customers who finds the system full doesn't enter but returns the immediately to the calling population. So the system such as whatever that we should take it in the finite or the infinite, so that we need to take it as the depending upon the effective of arrival. So that is the arrival rate, that is number who arrive and enter the system per unit. So it depends or it affect the entire system capacity. So the third point we are going to discuss next is the arrival process. The arrival process of infinite model is usually characterized in terms of IAT or successive customer, inter arrival time of successive customers. The arrivals may occur at scheduled time or random times. When at random times, the IAT inter arrival time, which is characterized by probability distribution. when it scheduled time, nothing will happen. So as the arrival of customer, arrival of the customer, any unit, so or any call, scheduled time in which is going to serve as per the service time assigned. But when it is come to the random time, so we should have a calculate with a random digit. We need to assign that one. So that's why we require probability distribution. The most important model of the random arrival is the Poisson arrival process. So and we discussed about arrival was 7 a.m. to 7:30 p.m. It is not a random fashion. The bus may arrive at a random fashion. That is the very important. So another thing, the most important model is the arrival random fashion. So here, so any arrival fashion that is AN, which represents the internal arrival time of the customer N minus 1 and the customer N. So A1, assume that AN is the A1. Is the arrival time of the first customer. You should calculate. Then for a Poisson arrival process, AN is always exponentially distributed with a mean of 1 by lambda time of units. So the arrival rate lambda is the customer per unit. So the number of arrival in the time of length we should take n of t, that would be taken as the n by n of t as the Poisson distribution with lambda t customer. So that is the here for a arrival process we have taken as in case of exponentially 1 by time. So next is the arrival of people to the restaurant, so which drives in the bank or service facility. So that is the good example of this arrival of a random process. So similarly, the Poisson arrival has been employed successfully a model of the arrival of people, restaurant, bank, service facility, arrival of telephone calls to the center, and arrival demand order of service or a product, the arrival failed to component a particularly repair facility, and so on. Now, second important of class arrival of schedule is the schedule time of PGC and office to the, because scheduled time will be taken and scheduled airport flight will be scheduled on a time, scheduled time it is going to fly. So this is the scheduled time. Okay. So third situation there is one occurs, assumed to be present in the queue. So the server in a, so this is never idle or never busy. This depends upon the lack of customer in the queue. For example, customer represent raw material for product in the sufficient raw materials assumed to be available, but actually the thing is not available. Another point here, for finite population model, the arrival process which is characterized incompletely in the different fashion, that we should not consider it as the same entity. So for example, let A1 of to the power I dot similarly A2 of the I, A2 is the suffix, okay. So A3 and AN, that could be arrival in the finite populations. So this is the successive runtime of the customer. We should say that with respective service time. So with respective service time, we should calculate it as S1 of I, S2 of I and successive service time, and WQ1, so the waiting, with the corresponding waiting time of the particular system. Similarly, WN of I equal to W of Q plus S service time. So total time spent in the system, W of Q with them, in the system I during the nth visit. So this is a good example. One example we have to take it as the one important finite application model, machine repair problem also. Another problem we should take that an example of arrival for process for a finite population model. That is the patient 3 in hospital example. So this is the status. patient 3. For instance, we should take all the arrival of the and any patient 3 status. So arrival process of finite, this is the finite population. So A1 of 3 arrival process of the third, because patient arrival we need to take it as first arrival of patient 3. Similarly, need attention of, because that should be in the waiting queue, W1 of 3 is equal to. So we should calculate the spent total time spent in the system W. So WQ of 3 plus service time of 1 of 3. By that time, A2 is the pending, because A1 is initially pending, next A2 is pending. Second arrival of patient 3, second arrival, and W2 of 3, that is the patient 3 status. W2Q, here Q1 will be Q2 plus need attention. So that could be is taken it as we had the previous calculation about that one. Successive service time also need to be taken into the account. This is a simple process of a successive arrival process of a finite population model of patient 3. This is not a number of 3 patients that will be taken to be continued if it is there diagrammatically. This is the patient 3 status, third patient. When a third patient come into the arrival process, what will happen? So that is the showing it as the arrival process, because the arrival process need to be considered more important in the characteristic of the queuing system. So next, we'll continue with queue behavior and queue discipline. So we know that it refers to the action of customer while in a queue waiting for the service to begin. So there is a possibility in customer will, we know that, will balk or leave their line is too long. We know that renege or leave after being the line when they see their line is moving too slowly, or you can say jockey, or move from one line to another if they think they have chosen a slow line. So here, queue discipline refers, we say that there are a lot of things, questions are available. Logical ordering of customer in the queue determine which customer will be chosen for service when server becomes always free. So here, what we say that the common queue discipline include first in, first out, last in, first out, service in random order. Shortest processing time for service according to the priority. In a manufacturing system, queue discipline are sometimes based on the due date and unexpected processing for a given type of the respective job. So that should be taken. The first in first out queue discipline implies that the service begins in the same order of arrival, but that customer could leave the system in a different order, especially in a different order because the different length of the service.
So now the fifth characteristic is service times and service mechanism. The service times of successive arrivals are so denoted by, we should take always capital letter S1, S2, S3, ... SN maybe, the constant or random duration. Service time maximum always will have a constant duration. There are certain cases we should take it as a random duration. So the next is the queuing system consist of a random service centers and interconnecting queues. We should have an example before going to that. So here we should use the letter capital S1, S2, S3, ... SN. So which is usually characterized as a sequence of independent and identically distributed random variable. So for examples, the exponential, Weibull, gamma, log normal, and one more is truncated normal distributions have all been used successfully as a model of service times in different situations. So usually here service are identically distributed for all customer of a given type, or you can call it as a class or priority, whereas customer of different type might have completely different service might be time distributions. So we will take an example, that is the, for example, server might work faster than usual when the waiting line is long, so thus effectively reducing the service time. So this is the example queuing system, which consists of a number of service centers and always interconnected queue. Okay, so the each service center consists of a servers which is denoted by C, small c, working in parallel. These are either single server, so always we should write single server C equal to 1. Multiple server should always write in the C is lies between, this is not 8, this is infinite. C is so less than infinity and always greater than 1. Greater than always 1 server, parallel server should be required. So this is the one example we had taken here. And in case of parallel service mechanism, are either this is equal to 1 or infinity, or in case of only unlimited servers, that C equal to infinite. A self-service facility is usually characterized having unlimited number of servers. Now this is the example. Consider a discount warehouse where customer may either serve themselves or wait for one of the three clerk. Assume that there are three clerk will be given here in this system. Discount warehouse with service center, either they have to take themselves, other three service persons are available. Assume that persons or this is the staff. So one of the clerk, one of the three clerk, then finally leave after paying a single cashier. So this arrival is like this, Q1, one staff will be here, Q2, similarly service center 1, service center 2, service center 3, and departure. So the cashing is the departure only one or arrival point. Okay, so the queue is all the service center will have their own queue because they can stand. The system is represented by all the diagram. This is the big subsystem consisting of queuing to service center 2 as shown in the detail like that figure. That is, we can call it a subsystem. This entire system, this subsystem, this is also subsystem. So here another figure will have that their own different. So now what it does, the person arrival, they might go either service center 1. So this is the, assume that self service, that service here mechanism is infinite service because self service, so anyone can come and then they can take. Okay, and service counter 2, so C is equal to 3. There are three clerks are available here, three clerks, service center 2. So here queue may be again in waiting line. So because those who are coming here, they need to wait for, because so these three has to serve. So after taking this, this is the counter only one cashier, because either self or are served by the server. So both should coming to in the queue. Q3 is obviously in waiting. The service center only one person will be available and depart. So what does happen here? So service times and service mechanism. So because of service mechanism here, cashier is one, but this is okay and this is okay. Here time may be again a delay because the only one person is going to serve. So another diagrammatically represent service center two. This is the diagrammatically discount to same thing. Assume that service 1, 2, 3. This is the service counter 2. We should have taken example here. So what does it? A customer requiring several servers simultaneously in the discount. Clerk might pick several small order at the same time, but it may take two of the clerk to handle the heavy item. So this is going to happen. But this is the very good in case of the previous example what we have taken, same subsystem we have taken extended here, but almost service center 2 with C is equal to 3 parallel server. So this service might be very good because the number of server may be increased. So that is the service mechanism. This is related to the service mechanism. But either the way, cashier should also increase because they need to pay only one door. Another example here, candy manufacturer line that consists of three machines separated by inventory process buffer. The first machine make and makes the candy and wrap the individual piece of candy. The second 50 pack will be doing is in a box. Third machine seal and wrap the box covering it. Two inventory buffers have the capacity of 1000 boxes each. So now the next, this is the figure, what it does. A system is modeled as having three service center, each center having C is equal to one server, always there, C is equal to one in all the cases. That is a machine. So with the queue, capacity constraint between the machine, it is assumed that sufficient supply of raw material is always available at the first queue. So because of the queue capacity constraint, machine one shut down. So whenever its inventory buffer Q2 is full, this Q2 is full, that machine one will be shut down. So which fills to the capacity, and machine 2 shut on where whenever the what is that one, its buffer empty. So in the brief, the system consists of three single server queue which in series with queue series with the queue capacity constraint and a continuous arrival stream at the first queue. So this is the how does take it the mechanism in case of one system fails or second system buffer is empty, and how does it handle by the another, because capacity of all that is given only 1000. So this is the how the service will be going to occur in the particular machine or any production system. So this is about what we talked about, all the characteristic of the queuing system, started with calling populations, the system capacity, the arrival process, queue behavior and queue discipline, service times and service mechanism with these two examples. Next we are going to see that queuing notations. So now come to the queuing notations. So recognizing diversity of the queuing system, Kendall, that's the name of the author, 1953, he has proposed a national system for parallel server, which has been widely adopted in all the application sector, and a bridged version of this convention based on the format of he has invented, like that A bar, B bar, C bar, C small, and N bar, K. These letters represents the following system characteristic. So A stands for here, notation of parallel system, A bar, B bar, C bar, N bar, K. So A represents the inter arrival distribution, and B represents always The service time distribution, C represents the number of parallel servers, N represents the system capacity, and K represents the size of polling population. So usually we should take all the cases, we should apply the A bar, B bar, C bar, N bar, K. So here commonly symbol A and B include M, so that is exponential or Markov distribution. D is the constant or deterministic. So EK, small k, Erlang of order k, EH is a phase type, H is a hyper exponential, and G is a general or arbitrary, and GI is general independent. This is the normal symbol notations will be used. So for example, so M bar, 1 bar, infinity, which indicates that a single server system that has unlimited queue capacity and infinite population of potential arrivals. Very simple notation here. So we had the abbreviation format is A bar, B bar, C bar, N bar, K. So A indicates that we had taken is the inter arrival of time distribution. Okay, we had taken. Another B is the service time, and C is the number of server. Here number of server 1 is given, and N represents the system capacity. This is the, they have given, that is the single server that has unlimited queue capacity and an infinite population, size of calling population, last one K. So infinite population, potential of arrival. Potential of arrival means we should take which represents the inter arrival of distribution. So that maybe we had used A and B include M is the maybe M and M maybe the exponential or Markov distribution. So where N and K are infinity, so here the finally we should write, because infinity can be neglected because only limited should be taken. So M bar 1, this we should call it as a symbolical notation. After this, we should write it as, and the queuing notation is M bar 1. So next one example, the nurse attending 5 hospital patients might be represented by M bar 1 bar 5 bar 5. So which indicates that particularly the nurse. So always M bar 1 bar 5 by 5. So the which represents the system is 5. Nurse is single, server is single, server, nurse is a server, and the capacity is the 5. Calling population is the 5 hospitals. Okay, single nurse, and exponential. This should be the exponential of potential arrivals. So that could be taken it as M bar 1 bar 5 bar 5. So there are a lot of additional queuing notation in the parallel system. They have just not denoted like that. Whenever we use a certain cases, so we need to apply this table. Next slide will have a table of this thing. So this is the queuing notation for parallel systems. There are a list of notations with abbreviations are given. So depending upon the applications, we should apply as along with our Kendall notation, that is the Kendall notation A bar, C bar, N bar, K. So P of N steady state probability of having N customer in the system. So whenever N customer in the steady state probability, we should use P of N. Then similarly, same thing P of N and T, time. Probability M customer, so at time T. And this the lambda arrival rate, always lambda E effective arrival rate, and mu is the service rate of any one of the server. This is a rho, server utilization. A of N, always inter arrival time between customer N minus 1, sometimes is N. S of N is service time of nth arrival customer. WN total time spent in the system, arrival of the customer, WN to the power Q, total time spent waiting in the queue customer, and L of T, the number customer in the system at time T, L of Q, LQ of, this is the Q, the number of customer Q at time T, L is the always long run time average number of customer in system, L of Q, long run average number of a customer in queue, the above is the system. Similarly, W is small w, long run average time spent time spent in the system per customer. And similarly, W of Q, same thing, long run average time spent in the queue per customer. So this is the simple abbreviation which will be used whenever it is required. So we should have it. So the next videos we will discuss very important performance, the long run measure of queuing system. So there just we will just discuss derivation is ready, is there the time average number system in the L, similarly the average time spent in the system per customer, that's W. Another one is conservation equation, that simple equation, L is equal to lambda arrival rate into waiting W, that should be taken. And the server utilization, so there are two way server utilization is there, in the G bar 1 bar infinity Q, this is the server utilization. Another one, G bar C bar infinity by infinity Qs, and server utilization and system performance, actually the content. So after that, then we have to concentrate on steady state behavior of the infinite population of model. And there is a one more thing very important point is single server queue with the poisson arrival and unlimited capacity, that is M bar G bar 1. That we need to study. So after that, the network of queue and rough cut modeling of an illustration, that we will concentrate on the next videos.